When calculating the freezing point of a solution that contains an electrolyte, you have to do some special calculations dealing with the molality of the solution. So we'll start out by first calculating the molality of the calcium chloride solution in water. Once we've calculated the molality of the calcium chloride in the solution, we have to take into account the fact that when calcium chloride dissociates, you're going to get three particles. You're going to get calcium ion, you're going to get two chloride ions. And so what that means is that if you have a 0.037 molal solution of calcium chloride, you're going to get 0.03727 molal calcium, but you're going to get double that of the chloride ion because there will be twice as many chlorides as there are calcium ions. So the total molality of the particles in the solution is actually going to be 0.1118 molal. And again, this is because the freezing point depression as well as boiling point elevation, both properties do not care what the ions in the solution are. All they care about is the concentration of total particles in the solution. And so that's what we have to calculate. And so just finding the calcium chloride molality is not going to be good enough. We have to multiply that essentially. In this case, we multiply it times 3 because we have a total of 3 particles that are going to be formed when calcium chloride dissociates. So now we'll go ahead and calculate the freezing point depression. We're going to use the freezing point depression constant for water, since water is the solvent here. And we're going to go ahead and plug in the corrected value, which is 0.1118 molar for the calcium chloride solution. Now at this point, we've calculated the freezing point depression. This number is not the freezing point. So what you have to do is take that number and subtract it from the freezing point of whatever solvent you're dealing with. So in this case, we're dealing with water. Water has a freezing point of 0, so it's going to be 0 degrees Celsius minus 0.208 degrees Celsius, and so the answer is going to be negative 0.208 degrees Celsius. And that's probably one of the most common mistakes that people make, is they just forget to subtract the freezing point depression from the original boiling point of the solvent. In some cases, you may be given what's called the Vant Hoff factor for a solute. And what this refers to is the extent of dissociation that the particles undergo when they dissolve into the solute. So, for example, sodium chloride, when it dissolves in water, under ideal conditions, you're going to get sodium ions, chloride ions. And what we've been taught is that if we started, for example, with 1 molar sodium chloride, we would get 1 molar sodium ions and 1 molar chloride ions. And that would give us a total of 2 molar total particles. But what the Vant Hoff factor does is that it tells us the actual number of particles that we're going to get when sodium chloride dissolves. And so it turns out that instead of getting 2 particles for every sodium chloride that dissolves, you actually only get 1.9 particles. So this has a Vant Hoff factor of 1.9. So how do we use that in our problem? So what this means, again, the Vant Hoff factor tells us what number we can multiply our original solution concentration by in order to get the actual concentration of dissolved particles in the solution. So a 1.9 for sodium chloride means that we take our 1.0 molar, multiply it times 1.9, and we're going to actually get 1.9 molar total particles in solution. So for these problems that we've been doing, where we deal with freezing point depression, boiling point elevation, and osmotic pressure, this could make a big difference. And so let's look at a problem that involves the Van't Hoff factor. So the problem says, what is the freezing point of a solution that contains 4.2 grams of sodium chloride in 125 grams of water? And what I've already done is I've calculated the molality of the sodium chloride solution. And that is, as I calculated, 0.57488 moles per kilogram. So when I go to calculate the freezing point depression, I'm going to have to take this into account. So I'm going to use the formula delta TF equals, and I'm going to put this I in here. I is the Van't Hoff factor times KF times the molality. And so we know, I just said for sodium chloride, the Van't Hoff factor was 1.9. So I'm going to go ahead and plug all these numbers in. So it's going to do 1.9 times 1.86 times 0.57488 molal. And so my freezing point depression will be 2.03 degrees Celsius. So the freezing point then is going to be negative 2.03 degrees Celsius. And that's because I'm going to have to subtract my freezing point depression from the actual freezing point of water.